بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وبعد. Dear students, it's great pleasure for me to meet you again in this course and to start today with lecture 3. In advance, I'd like just to remind you that I have received so many complaints from the students who really want me to speak or to explain some grammatical rules in Arabic. Really, I'll try to do my best to balance between those who want me to speak in Arabic and those who want me to keep explaining the lectures in English. Anyhow, first of all, I'd like just to give you what are the elements of the lectures. Just to mention here the elements of this lecture. Yes, let's see here. First of all, we, inshallah, try to cover these four elements of this lecture. We'll start by, let's say, revising or just to explain the difference between A and, because some students have misunderstood when to use A and when to use an. Then we will move to talk about the pronouns. After that, I'll try to explain the use of verbs to be in all cases, in the present, in the past, and in the perfect. And finally, we'll try to preview vocabulary by guessing and infer the meaning of some important words that I need you to focus and try to learn them in details. Yes, let's first try to talk about the first element, which is articles. And we will not talk about all articles, but just to talk about indefinite articles. By the way, we have in English just two indefinite articles. They are A and M. Yeah? Let's start by talking about A. الإخوان اللي مو فاهمين شو الموضوع، الموضوع بتكلم عن أدوات التعريف الغير معرفة، في أن فقط أداتين اللي هو الA والM. A really used before singular nouns that begin with consonant. So be careful that we can't use A before a plural noun. ما تستخدم في قبل الأسماء الجمع. Just before singular, مفرد. Okay? And these singular nouns should start or begin with consonant. If you ask me about consonant, I'll tell you that consonant are about 21 letters or alphabet in English. 21 حرف ساكن في اللغة الإنجليزية. نستخدم مع قبلهم A. Then, or the other article is an. So an also used before singular noun. So both A and an are used before singular nouns. الA والan تستخدم قبل الأسماء المفردة. But the difference, الفرق بين A وan, is that A, as we said, before consonant, and an before singular nouns that begin with vowels. Vowels, حروف المتحركة. And in English, we have, you know, we have 21 letters or alphabet consonant, and the other are vowel. Vowels are mentioned here. You see them in the red colors. We have five alphabet or five letters called vowels. الحروف المتحركة. A, E, I, O, and U. And I want you to underline U, because U sometimes pronounce A and sometimes pronounce U. When it is pronounced U, it is considered as consonant. حرف U إذا كان لفظه U like university, like unit, هذا نعتبره إحنا حرف ساكن, وبالتالي نستخدم قبله حرف الآ الأيضا. إذا كان لفظه if it is pronounced like umbrella, like uncle, so we consider it as vowels. Okay, so this is, I think it is enough for you to differentiate between A and N. تفرقوا بين A و N. It's very clear and very easy, and to just to make you sure that you understand this, try to see these words in English. Notice that all of them begin with a red letter or a red alphabet, just to explain to you or to show you whether the letter or the alphabet is consonant or vowel. Yeah. So what do you think of the first one here? When you have a book, book is singular, مفرد, and it begins with the letter B. So B here is a consonant, so we must use before it, or we should use both the letter, yeah, A. So we say a book, a book. Orange, you see orange here, you see the letter here, we call this vowel, so we can't use A. And if you can't decide, you will see the pronunciation when you speak the word orange is very difficult, so it clear that you use here N. See, so here N orange. And what about car? You see car here is a singular, begins with C, so C is consonant, C حرف حرف ساكن. So we use, this is capital letter, or you can use like this, yeah. Story, the same. A story, because it starts with the letter S. Egg, egg, singular, begins with vowel. So we write here an egg. And the last word here, lecture. So lecture is singular, begins with the letter L. So L is consonant, L حرف ساكن. So we write a lecture. Yeah? So another group of words here, we do them quickly. So man, we say a man. Umbrella, we write an. And apple here, we write an apple. Pencil, a pencil. You see? And the last, or the next one, table, we say a table. We say a table. Yeah. Then the last one, email. So I have received an email or an email, an email. We write an. Yeah. So I hope that I really believe and think that it's very clear to differentiate between a and an. Let's move to before moving, just to give you the notes here, remember that all the above words are singular. يعني الملاحظة الأولى أن تذكروا جميع الكلمات مفردة. Yeah. Sometimes we have singular nouns. أحيانا بيكون في عنا أسماء مفردة لكن ما نستطيع نستخدم A أو an. وهذه تقريبا أنا حاولت أني أنا ألخصها في كلمات اللي هي أسماء العلم، أسماء الأشخاص proper nouns، أسماء المدن، الأيام والشهور، وطبعا في عندنا بعض الأسماء المعرفة تعريفا معنويا. Again, so before proper nouns, no need to use any article, whether it is definite or indefinite. قبل أسماء الأشخاص، أسماء المدن، أسماء الأشهر والأيام والعواصم وبعض الدول، الأسماء المشهورة معرفة تعريف معنويا لا نستخدم معها أي أداة تعريف، لا ولا آن ولا ذا ولا ب. أوكي. Let's try here to do the exercise here, how the final test will be like. So let's see here the exercise quickly here. Could you please give me, so here you are asked to choose which article is correct here. Piece of cake. So piece is singular, piece مفرد, and it begins with the letter P. P is consonant, P حرف ساكن ومفرد نستخدم معها the letter. The answer is C. So this is the answer. So could you give me a piece of cake? Yeah. The next one. Number two here, dog dash, dog is dash animal. So what do you think here? Dog مفرد singular begins with D consonant حرف ساكن. So we say a dog is an animal. C, a dog is an animal. I'm sorry for the mistake last time about insect or about ant. So you say an ant is an insect or an animal, because insect is a kind of animal. Yes. Number three, I visited Ahmed last week. Yeah. If you think of this sentence, I visited dash Ahmed last week, here we can't use any of the articles. Why? Because Ahmed is a proper noun. لأنه أحمد اسم علم ما بنستخدم أي أداة تعريف. So we use nothing. This means that we can't use any of the articles. Yes. Number four, the capital of Saudi Arabia is Riyadh. Riyadh is also a name of a city or a capital. So no need to put anything before Riyadh. So it's also nothing before Riyadh. Yeah. Number five, I finished, you see this, I finished dash unit in English language course. unit here is a singular noun begins with a vowel, but here the pronunciation of the vowel is not a. We say unit, unit, not unit, not unit. So in this case we consider U as a consonant. So we use here, I finished a unit. Number five, number the next one, I take, you see umbrella, just to show you the difference between U and U in 5 and 6. الفرق بين اليونت والامبريلا انه اليونت نقول احنا يو يو but امبريلا we say so we consider umbrella U in umbrella as vowel and U in unit as consonant. So we say this here, I take an umbrella when it rains. Yeah, so I think after this demonstration and illustration of the use of A and N, I think everything is clear. أتمنى أن يكون القاعدة واضحة. No need to give more details. It's very clear. Yeah. Let's move here. If you remember last time, or maybe in the first or the second lecture, we really explained, let's say, in a quick summary, the pronouns. But here, really, I try to give you all pronouns in English and how or why we have different forms of each pronoun. If you see the table here or the chart, we will start A by personal pronouns, الضمائر الشخصية. And we have seven pronouns. عنا سبع ضمائر. Yeah. We will start by I. You see I, he, she, it, you, we, they. No need to give you the meaning of each one in Arabic. They are very clear. Here in this column, they are under subject. Subject يعني حالة الفاعل للضمير. In the second one, object يعني مفعول به, object. And the second one, possessive اللي هو يسمى ضمير الملكية. And the next one is possessive but at the end of the sentence, يعني ضمير الملكية في نهاية الجملة اللي هو البوزيتيف الثاني. And then reflexive, الضمير العكسية. You see number one, let's focus on the first one, I اللي معناها أنا. I in the subject case we say I go to university at 8 o'clock. So the subject of the sentence, الفاعل في الجملة هي I. So this is the form or the shape or the way we write the pronoun I. If it is in the object, we change, we can say Ali gave I. We can't say this sentence. Ali gave, because I here changed into object case, اتحولت إلى حالة المفعول به, we change I into me. The third one, my. You say my here, possessive, ملكية. You say, this is my book. We can't say this is me book or this is I book. Yeah? This is my book. And the next one, mine. We change my into mine when we put the pronoun at the end of the sentence. Like this way. This is my car. This is my car. So my before a noun. Yeah? But we can say a sentence in another way, like this. That car is mine. Stop. Full stop. You see? Yeah. And the last column here is about reflexives. You know that reflexives are used just to give more emphasis that the action is done by the subject. Like this one. I did the homework myself, or I myself did the homework. So you repeat and put myself in order to show me that you yourself did the homework. So this is applied on all subjects. هذا بينطبق على الضمائر جميعا. Let's move to another type of pronouns. They are called demonstrative pronouns. ضمائر الإشارة. ضمائر الإشارة. We have the same in Arabic language. Yes. We have pronouns for a place. Yeah. And pronouns to refer for the location of something. So when we say here, so something is very near to you, near. So here, اللي معناها هنا. If you refer to something that is away or far from you, you say there. So here, هنا, there, هناك. This is for a place. هذا ضمائر المكان. الإشارة للمكان. We have for things. When we say for things or people, when we say this near and that is far. So this معناها هذا وفار معناها ذلك. That ذلك. Okay? This is the difference. This للقريب وذات للبعيد. المفرد. إذا في حالة الجمع in the plural case we say these